AverMedia RECentral for recording software. So this is one of the good things that you get out of the box with your capture card or the Streaming Duo, is you have access to this record software. Now, I will say I have mixed feelings about the software, only in that, one, while the software is really simple and easy to set up, if you look down here in the lower right-hand corner, it is taxing my computer. And while my computer is a little older, I did build it to be future-proof. So what do I mean by future-proof? Well, in the case of this particular laptop, I have a Core i7-6820HK CPU, and I have 64 gigabytes of RAM and an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 980M. And here you can see in the lower right-hand corner, I'm using up 40% of my CPU just for this program and 33 gigabytes of RAM. This is not including the OBS software that I'm running right now to record this particular setup. Now, I will say, just having this on and I'm not streaming anything or recording anything, this is using 19,600 megabytes and 15% of my CPU. In a similar setup using OBS and actually recording, I use 800 megabits worth of memory and much less CPU. So just know that if you're using an older system, you may run into problems actually streaming. Now, in the background here, you've just been watching my Roku background as it's cycling, but let's take a look at what we can actually do with the software should you have a computer that actually can support running it. So what we're looking at here is the main capture area. You have single capture, you have multi. Multi will allow you to add layers, so a camera. Right now I'm on single because I just need this to capture what's on my TV set, or in your case, the PlayStation or Xbox, whatever you're trying to capture off of your TV. Here we're indicating the Live Gamer Mini. We can always come over here and edit anything. So here we go. Quick little options. We're not going to mess with that too much. Over here on the right, you have record, stream, and then multi-stream. You have different recording profiles that you can set up. Right now I'm on optimal, and it's doing 1920 by 1080 at 59.9 frames a second. Here, you can actually see the available space that you have on your hard drive. So if you have multiple hard drives like I do, you can indicate to the hard drive that actually has the most space for saving. Here you can see there is a microphone mute button, and you can see you can mess with your levels right there, as well as audio that you're getting. You also have your mute device preview. You've got your audio mixer here, so opening this up will let you really dig in and change settings as you like. And right here, you have full screen mode. The beauty of this program is that it's really start setup. There's even a wizard that you walk through right here. If you ever need to reset up the wizard, you click on that and you can set it up streaming, recording, and it walks you through most of the settings. Now, one of the other things I like is this help button. It actually has a visual overlay as to what the individual components mean. So if this is the first time you're messing with any type of streaming software, this would be really good to kind of help you get started. You can enable always on top mode, or you can have a minimized mode. We've been operating in the maximum mode so that we could see all of our options. Over here, coming to the wheel, we just click on settings and it will bring us into our settings. You have options for general, shortcuts if you want. I will admit, I did not use shortcuts in OBS until much later in my usage of OBS. I highly recommend setting up shortcuts. It'll save you a lot of time, especially if you're using a single monitor setup and you're trying to play a game. Profile management, you can export or import your profiles, and then you have about. One of the interesting things is you have a media share option. So if you wished to share media, and here you go, this is media that I have just kind of sitting there from tests, but you can share that right through the system. And then we're going to hit our record button. This middle button, if you select it, will actually bring you to the AverMedia website for more information. Now, this is a separate download, and it did not come pre-installed with the drivers for the capture card. But just know, if you're starting out and you don't want to necessarily try to set up OBS Studio on your own or look through a guide. This is a very simple, straightforward, quick setup for streaming, setup for recording software. Again, your computer will have to be a little beefier in order to handle it. So when you're ready, all you would do is you come here, click record, or that would be stream if you were on the streaming option. You can select for snapshots if you so chose, and then you would watch your countdown timer here as you record and lose writable space. But don't worry, if you pay attention to your capture card and don't see your numbers here, once it starts blinking red, you'll know that you're getting kind of close to full hard drive and you should stop streaming. So again, really simple to use, straightforward streaming software that can be used with your AverMedia capture card.